One person asked why, but the real question is why not?
Ma'am?
Howdy.
Are we there yet, Freddi?
Almost.
Where's Luther? Oh, there he is.
Sure is nice of your cousin Calico to teach us all about raising hogfish.
She'll be glad for the help. It's hard to run a big ranch all by yourself.
Will we get to wear 10-gallon hats?
I think a 5-gallon hat is more your size.
Ha-ha.
Come on, let's go.
I'm at least 7 gallons, Freddi. 6.5 minimum.
He looks so heartbroken there. The case of the Hogfish Rustler of Briny Gulch. The chanting sounds like some cult or something. Alright, so I said this on my Tumblr, but like, okay, so power supply blew in my old computer, I think, so it's gonna be fixed. Probably gonna take a month. I don't know, because I have to ship it to him and then... it's so annoying or something. Okay, I might be exaggerating with the month thing, but yeah, no Final Fantasy X or Shadow Hearts 2 until then. But I will be uploading Kingdom Hearts and this kind of stuff.
I've never been to a real ranch before. I can't wait.
Neither can I.
Well, we're waiting right now.
When I get to be older than you, will I be bigger than you too?
We'll just have to wait and see, I guess. Gosh, Luther. I'm glad you're here with me.
I'm glad too.
OTP.
Let's hurry up and get to the ranch.
Yeah. This is turning out to be a pretty exciting vacation.
Oh my god, guys, it's so exciting.
I'd feel a lot more westerny if I had a good hat to wear.
We'll get you one. Don't worry. There's Cousin Calico's ranch.
I'm raring to go.
Hi, Cousin Calico.
Oh, hello, Freddi. Howdy, Luther.
We're ready to help out. Which way to the hogfish?
Well, it seems we got a little problem there. See, my prize-winning hogfish herd has been rustled.
Rustled?
What does that mean?
Somebody came and took them without asking.
That's not right.
No, it's not. And a hogfish requires proper care. I think they might be in real trouble. I just don't know what to do.
Did you call the police?
I think the sheriff's gone out of town. And I need to stay here at the ranch in case the hogfish get away and come home.
The sheriff is the culprit.
All the worrying
I
have to do.
We'll help you, Cousin Calico. Luther and I will find the hogfish and catch those rustlers.
Yeah!
Thank you both. You'll be doing me a real good turn.
Did you see the rustlers who took your hogfish, Cousin Calico?
No, but you might ask some of the folks in town. Maybe they saw something.
Alrighty. It's a purple sea urchin.
Look, Freddi! A purple sea urchin! We're rich!
This game teaches kids that money is just lying around.
Here we are in Briny Gulch.
This must be the town square!
Let's go ask some of the people who live here if they know anything about those rustlers.
I don't think I ever beat this one. I do remember getting stuck in it.
Customers! Hello and welcome to Just Buckles! I'm Nelson Tosso. How can I help you today?
I'm Freddi, and this is Luther. And we're helping my cousin, Calico Catfish.
Rustlers took all of her hogfish.
Rustlers? Well, I wouldn't know anything about that.
Hmm.
these plans.
Oh, those are the blueprints for the custom belt buckles I make. They feature a stylish arching metal back with a personalized letter on the front. Any letter the customer wants.
I'll bet they look nice.
Oh, they're very popular.
Does he have a picture of himself up there, or is that his son?
Did you see this picture?
It's my son. Half Nelson. He was real cute as a baby. Don't you think?
He has your forearms.
What? That's a weird thing to say.
Do you work out a lot?
Luther, are you hitting on him?
Why? No. Making buckles is hard work. So I don't really need to work out.
Is that what I think it is?
It's ink.
Oh!
What do you think it was?
Hi, I'm Freddi Fish, and this is my best friend, Luther.
Orca Squid, of the Santa Clara Squids, and these would be Perry and Ape.
Hello?
Apricot.
Some rustlers took my cousin's hogfish. Have you seen or heard anything suspicious?
Rustlers taking your cousin's hogfish sounds mighty suspicious to me already.
What?
Hi, I'm Freddi, and this is my pal Luther.
Well, hello! Eight-fingered Phil! Doctor, piano-ology, at your service.
We're looking for some hogfish rustlers. Have you seen anything suspicious?
Rustlers? No, I wouldn't know a thing about that. I know the piano, and it knows me, but that's about it. Sorry. I can't help you out.
That's okay.
The piano knows
Thanks
you?
Anyway.
Look, Freddi, maybe this is a clue.
Meet at the Rusty Rustler at high tide. Memorize the combination and then eat this note, 926. I'll bet the rustlers left this.
I wonder why they didn't eat the note like it says.
It probably tastes like paper. We'll hang on to it. That combination must be important.
The paper probably tastes like paper.
Howdy, youngsters. I'm Saltwater Stella, owner and operator of the Soda Loon. What can I do for you?
We wanted to ask you if you've seen any rustlers around here lately.
Rustlers? Well, there were a couple of suspicious characters in here yesterday. They might have been rustlers. They sat at that table right over there.
Thank you.
Why do you think they were suspicious?
What can I do for you kids?
One peppermint soda, please.
You bet.
I clicked on it. Oh. What else do they have? When we didn't have to even pay for it.
One orange peel soda, please.
One soda on the house.
No, orange peel soda. And they're underwater and they're drinking drinks. What else do you got?
One vanilla beet soda, please.
Coming right up.
Okay, why is that, why is it purple?
Ouch! You can really taste the beet.
I want another one. I want to get something that isn't gross.
One prickly pear soda, please.
You bet.
Okay, well, I like pears. Confused me for the longest time because I was like, why do they keep falling and breaking? I want to drink a soda. Then I figured out I had to click on it.
I think I got a prickle stuck in my tongue.
I like the prickly pear flavor.
Okay, that was weird. Let's try it one more time.
One sassafras soda, please.
Coming right up.
Me, listen. I want to talk to you about that note.
Come on, let's check out that hatch.
Okay. It won't open!
It's locked!
Wait a minute! Didn't I see a combination written somewhere?
No, you didn't. I didn't see any combination written anywhere. Is there anything over here? Okay, it's a cult and everyone is in on it.
Road closed due to construction.
Back shortly.
We found a clue!
A clue? Well, I'll be. What is it?
It's a note that says to meet at the Rusty Rustler.
The Rusty Rustler? That's the old shipwreck behind the soda loon. Been a rustler hideout for generations. I wonder why I didn't think of that.
Yeah,
had a lot on your mind.
You reckon they're holed up there now?
There's only one way to find out.
Okay, is Calico a boy or a girl or like neither or what is they? Okay, did we see a combination written somewhere? Like, did we?
Maybe sometime we could have a custom belt buckle made.
Sure, but right now, we've got to do something about those rustlers. Have you heard anything that might help lead us to the rustlers?
No, I'm afraid not.
He's lying. Okay, but I don't see any combination anywhere or whatever.
Mr. Fingers, could I learn to play the piano like that?
Why, sure you could. You know, You two remind me of two of my own 17 children.
Really? What are their names?
4 and 11. When you have 17 kids, it's much easier that way.
Okay.
Meet at the Rusty Rustler at high tide. Memorize the combination and then eat this note. 926.
Oh, 926.
This shouldn't be too hard. We just have to punch in the combination. 0, 1. 0, 9.
9, 2, 6.
1, 2, 9, 8, 7, 6. We did it! It's open! I guess the lock was the only thing holding the door on.
What's up with her mouth?
Darn it, what's that racket?
Someone's coming!
Hurry!
Aw, fiddlesticks! The door came off again. Well, I guess I'll just have to sit here and stand guard.
Oh my god, this guy's creepy.
I wonder if they still called it standing guard if you're sitting down.
That must be one of the rustlers.
I hear the hogfish in there. Let's go, Luther. Peace.
Hey, Freddi, can we eat this note now like it says?
Well, I guess we won't need the combination anymore.
What the hell, Luther?
I can see why the rustlers didn't eat it. It tasted like paper.
What did you expect?
It's rustlers only in the hideout. Oops, I didn't think I was supposed to say it was a hideout.
We might be rustlers. How do you know we're not rustlers?
That's easy. You're not dressed like rustlers. If you were a rustler, you'd have a 10-gallon hat like mine, a belt buckle like mine, and a fashionable bandana.
All rustlers dress exactly alike?
Yep, we all wear the latest rustler gear. You can see from this picture in WrestleMania magazine.
A blue 10-gallon hat, a big old belt buckle with an S on it, and a bandana.
Since you're not wearing these things, you must not be rustlers, so you can't come in, because this hideout is for rustlers only.
Okay, thank you. This is the rustler hideout, all right. I'm sure the hogfish are inside.
What are we going to do?
We've got to get some new clothes.
He just admitted to us that they were rustlers. So, like, okay.
All right, you hogfish. Quiet down or else. Or else I'm calling Mr. Big.
What? Is he gonna call the squid father?
It was probably just the current.
I guess.
It was probably just the current, as opposed to the wind.
How much would it cost to have a custom belt buckle made?
Well, seeing as how you said you're Calico's cousin and all, I do the job for free if you brought me the materials.
Thank you, Nelson. That's very generous.
Don't mention it.
So, All we need to make a belt buckle is that piece of metal with a round top and some kind of letter, right?
That's correct!
I guess whoever was working here is done now. You two look like you've got trouble.
You can say that again. We made this floor for the big square dance tomorrow.
Only we found out it has to be, well, square.
And we are out of wood. We need some more to start over.
A piece about 7 feet by 7 feet ought to do it.
Alrighty.
That's a nice screwdriver you have there.
Thanks.
Do you think we could borrow it for a while?
No, we might need it to work on this dance floor. Maybe later when it's finished.
Okay, yeah, you're really busy right now, I can see that.
Good evening, ma'am.
Sir.
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Gil Barker, and I represent the Biloxi Premium Gum and Wheel Nut Company, third largest distributor of bubble gum and wheel nuts in the Upper Western Hemisphere.
I'm Freddi Fish, and this is my pal Luther.
My employers have authorized me to clear out my inventory to make room for next year's models. Everything must go. Therefore, I, Gil Barker, will be offering you prices so outrageously low that you'll have to bend over to see them.
Great. Friendly reminder to Gil Barker. You owe Shady Shark 20 clams.
Aw, that name sounds a little
pay
shady.
Up pronto. What's this?
Oh, that's nothing. It's a poem I was writing.
Oh, you dod with your skin so
that's
white.
That's an awfully strange poem.
Oh boy, a real 10-gallon hat.
Thief!
Gosh, I'm sorry. I didn't know there was anyone under there.
You could have knocked!
On a hat? I'll bet that anchor is almost as heavy as my Uncle Blubber. And he's a whale!
What?
Look, it's a suitcase.
A soup case?
Phew! It's no use. It won't budge. This buoy looks a little tired.
It's barely floating.
Boo-hoo.
Watch out for the jellyfish, Luther. They can sting you.
Okay.
We made it!
I knew we could do it!
Timing?
It's a crank handle.
What's it doing here all by itself? Shouldn't it be attached to something?
Yeah, I doubt it belongs in this cave. I wonder how it got in here anyway.
Good question. Oh, boy! I see another purple sea urchin!
Does this go to this?
That's not gonna do me any good.
Okay. I don't know, it sort of matches. Oh, what is that thing over there?
Hmm.
long Finn Clifford, slack tongue Jack.
What?
Crooked hat Luke, crazy hat tongue Buddha. Wow, there are a lot of criminals in this place. Should we like be here? Okay, maybe I'll buy some gum. Hope I don't need it before I need the nuts.
We'd like to buy your pack of bubble gum, please.
Excellent, excellent. Super Rubber Bubble is the most durable gum on the market. You won't be disappointed. Now, the gum is 2 purple sea urchins, so you can give me the second one right away. Or, if you like, I can start a gum layaway plan for you, and I'll give you the gum when you pay me the balance.
That's fair. Here's the other purple sea urchin for the pack of gum.
Splendid, splendid. Here you go. It's my last pack. Maybe even the last pack in the entire hemisphere.
Oh my god.
Made a wise purchase.
Thank you.
No refunds.
Bandana you've got there?
Sure is. Very handy. Although sometimes I wish I had something sturdier to carry my gear in.
My name's Freddi Fish, and this is my best pal, Luther.
Howdy, kids. Folks call me Sahara Swim.
We're helping my cousin Calico. Her hogfish were taken by some rustlers.
Rustlers, eh? Well, I wouldn't know about that. I've known a few wrestlers in my day, but no rustlers to speak of.
Wrestlers.
Whatever you're cooking smells good.
It's Sahara Slim's special super stew. My own recipe. Oh. Not quite ready.
Alright, we need the 7x7 one. Look, a purple sea urchin.
Look, Freddi! A purple sea urchin!
Huh, free wood.
We're rich!
This should be useful.
How did you do that?
That's my special secret.
Okay.
Keep them on ice until I get back. Stop. Sign it. You know who.
Oh my god, they're all in on it? Urgent.
Yes, sir.
Oh. Oh, hi, kids.
Hello.
That's not gonna do me any good.
Yes, it is.
Here, can you use this piece of wood for your floor?
Say, that looks about right.
Perfect.
Thanks a lot. We owe you one.
You're welcome.
Our work here is done.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Coffee break?
Exactly.
They're all gonna like trip on it when they're dancing. It looks horrible.
Now that your floor is finished, do you think we can borrow your screwdriver for a while?
Sure. In fact, you can keep it. Consider it payment for a job well done.
Gee, thanks.
no. The other way?
Hello?
Are you the mailman?
No, I'm Freddi Fish.
Go away. I'm waiting for an important package.
This is sad.
Oh no. It's missing a handle on the lid. That's why the lid won't shut. I don't think I need that right now. It's an old shoe.
Shoe?
It's just a pile of junk.
Oh boy! I see another purple sea urchin!
It's a bone.
Doesn't he have anything better to do?
Maybe if we give him something to eat, we can swim past him while he's busy.
Good idea. Boy, that was fast.
I don't think that was enough time for us to swim past.
No, I don't think so.
Yum. Just throw it. Just throw it, Freddi. What's going on?
That ought to keep that shark busy for a while.
It's a shark?
Actually, he looks very happy. I like this silver starfish. Let's take it with us.
Okay.
I just like this thing. I just picked it up and I like it.
Let's take this starfish instead of the other one.
Okay.
I don't know which one I need.
Freddi Fish, and this is my best buddy, Luther.
Hello, I'm you.
That's silly. You're not Freddi.
No, you, like the letter U.
Just U? Is it short for something?
Yes, it's short for Uriah, Jedediah, Euripides, Algernon, Fortescue, Forsyth, and...
What a coincidence! That's my name!
We'll just call you U.
Most folks do.
It's addressed to E. Tippett.
Hey, you! That's your wagon over there, right?
Yep, it broke down, so I'm delivering the mail on foot. Takes a little longer that way, though.
It looks like the wheel on this wagon has fallen off. Maybe we can fix it. The wheel looks like it just needs a new nut to hold it onto the wagon.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so that's in a sixagon? I don't know what it is.
How long has it been since your wagon broke down?
Little over 2 years.
It looks like you've gone about 5 feet since then.
Yep. Making pretty good time. Pretty good time.
Oh my god, that's depressing.
Are you ready to start?
Start what?
Here's a fun game. Pop the bubbles before they run into you.
I don't want to play this anymore.
There's a handle missing from this crank. There! It fits perfectly! Now we've got a handle on that sail.
I gotta handle it to you.
Phew. Here, let me help.
He's slapping himself in the face.
Yeah! We did it, Luther! Why is the room spinning?
It's not, Luther. You are.
Oh, that's better.
Okay, so what did that do?
Hey, look! This place is filled with water now!
What is that? Texture seems weird.
It's lemongrass.
Is that anything like lemonade?
It's a little more sour than lemonade is.
Boy, you're not kidding! I kinda like it though.
Hey, Luther! What's round and purple and pokey?
Ink! Is it on me?
No, silly. It's a purple sea urchin over there.
Oh. I wasn't afraid.
S. S. I might be able to use this. G. S.
Is that how they get high? Oh my goodness.
Luther! This is an air pump. You should be more careful.
Oh, sure. Now you tell me.
But why would you just put your mouth on it and then... I don't understand this.
That's got it!
Coincidentally, it was the exact correct size.
All right. What about cake? Will you eat cake?
What's going
Here,
on?
Try it. But it's chocolate.
What's going on?
It's pepper.
Really?
Bless you.
Wow.
It's blood.
It's cayenne.
Cayenne?
Cayenne is kind of hot.
It feels like my tongue's on fire.
It is on fire. Oh,
is
my
it?
God.
No, it looks okay.
Whew.
They're kind of cute.
Here, can you make us a belt buckle with this on it?
Sure, just bring me a rounded piece of metal to use as the back part, and I'll get to work.
All right, so that's what I need, like a rounded piece of metal. I could have sworn I could go down there. Guess not.
We'd like to buy one of your wheel nuts, please.
Certainly! Now! The nuts cost 3 purple sea urchins, so I'll start you on one of our nut layaway plans. And you can have your nut when you've paid me the other 2 purple sea urchins. And may I say that a fickle fit wheel nut is really an excellent investment.
Yes.
I agree.
Here's another purple sea urchin towards our wheel nut.
Very good. Let's see. That leaves only 1 more purple sea urchin before the fabulous Fickle Fit wheel nut is all yours.
Here's the last purple sea urchin for our wheel nut. Can we have it now?
Of course! You can select any shape you like. And if it doesn't work out for you, you can bring it back and exchange it for a different one.
This one looks good. Thank you.
No, thank you.
Can we buy another wheel nut?
We don't need another wheel nut.
Good evening, sir. May I interest you in...
You got the 20 clams you owe me, Gil?
Not exactly.
How much is not exactly?
I've got a few purple sea urchins.
You know, my dogfish needs an operation.
Don't worry! I've got a really big deal about to go down.
Yeah? What is it?
All I can say is, it's really big! I'll have your clams in a couple of days.
Well, okay. Whatever you got going, I hope it's good.
But his dogfish needs an operation.
It's real good.
Guys, his dogfish needs an operation. I'm really concerned about it.
Hey, I've got an idea. Be free, little boy.
Is it coming back down?
I don't think so, Luther.
Oh, bye-bye, buoy.
That wouldn't work.
Look, Luther. This suitcase had a 3-ton anchor on top of it, and it's not even scratched.
Wow!
What's over here again? Okay, we don't need to go in here anymore. What's inside the suitcase, though? Not gonna tell me? Okay. Saddest thing, I don't understand.
We did it.
It's fixed, and it'll stay on there, right? We don't have to use any glue or anything.
Careful there. Don't ever mention G-L-U-E around old Elmer. Spooks him something awful.
What's he got against glue?
What the hell? But what's he got against glue?
My package! At last.
Mr. Tippett, do you think we could have this old mailbox door now that you're not using it anymore?
Sure. Take it and leave me to Hermit in peace.
Thank you. Hello, Mr. Tippett?
Go away. I'm busy.
What's there to do inside a mailbox?
I'm hermiting.
Oh. Is hermiting hard work?
Very. And you have to be alone to do it.
I relate a lot to this guy. Here you go. Here's your suitcase.
Here. This suitcase looks a lot sturdier than that bandana.
Over this fence for you, so count them and go to sleep.
is going on?
Please just go to sleep. Please.
Know what to do about the hat.
Here, this is for the belt buckle.
Okay, stand back.
That's
missing is a belt. Here you go.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Mr. Torso.
Please, call me Nelson.
Gobi, I'm at my wit's end. These hogfish are driving me crazy. They won't eat or sleep, and they're so noisy! Where'd they get the accordion?
I don't know. Did you try telling them that story about your trip to Akron? That always puts me to sleep.
Oh, thanks a lot. I'm going to have to call Mr. Big again.
Dude!
The Squid Father.
It's just not right. Yep.
Are you sure you don't know anything about the Rustlers?
I heard that Rustlers took some hogfish belonging to the cousin of a young girl near here. I haven't seen her.
Oh, so she is a girl.
But if I was looking, I'd look in the soda loon.
Wait, no. The cousin of a young girl. They're talking about Freddi. So I still don't know what gender.
Yup.
Alright, so I'm guessing I have to use this to dye the thing.
Did you try singing This Little Piggy, like I said? Well, try it. Listen, I gotta go, customers.
You play the piano very well.
Why, thank you, little lady.
Do you play requests?
Sure. What would you like to hear?
Pop Goes the Weasel?
Coming right up.
What can I do for you kids?
One pumpkin soda, please.
One soda on the house.
I go in and come out again, will be another scene? No. So I'm guessing it has something to do with... finding... with dyeing that hat blue with that thing? With the thing? Hat. Something starfish. What does the do with the starfish?
Gee, Luther, you're about the best friend a fish could have.
Aw, thanks.
Go to where that hat was again.
Excuse me, Mr.
Shrimp's the name. Used to be Sheriff Shrimp, but now I guess it's just plain Shrimp.
What happened to the sheriff part?
They took my silver star. You can't be a sheriff without a silver star. Oh. Folks won't respect you.
Maybe we could help you get your star back.
Yeah!
I'll tell you what, this county would owe you a great service if you did.
Should've kept a silver one. I mean, that was the odd one out. So it was probably the one that I needed, which it was.
Starfish. Let's take it instead of the other one.
It's just like the one the sheriff was talking about.
I was wrong about the sheriff being the culprit, I guess. I mean, everyone was in on it except for the sheriff, so I was about as wrong as I could be. Huh.
Here, I believe this is yours.
My starfish! Yahoo! I can't thank you all enough. Anything you need, you just ask.
How about that nifty 10-gallon hat?
Sure, I won't be needing that old thing anymore. Now if you'll excuse me, there are laws to be enforced. Rustlers to be found, Sheriff Shrimp is back in town.
But we know where the rustlers are.
You there, that's a loading zone.
What?
Looks like it's still up to us to catch those rustlers and rescue the hogfish.
Let's ride!
Yeah!
What does that even mean?
Oh boy, a 10-gallon hat! This is great! How do I look?
Like you need a smaller hat.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
All I ever wanted was to be a hogfish rancher. I had no idea it would be so much work.
Maybe there are some tricks to it that we don't know about.
Yeah? Well, I'm going back in. Don't let any non-rustlers inside, okay?
Radio!
Much.
It's the ink more than anything.
Looks nicer now.
All right, we got everything.
Luther, you stay here while I try to get past the guard.
Okay.
Hold it! This is a rustler's only area. I can tell you're not a rustler. You're not wearing a 10-gallon hat. You don't have a big ol' rustler-style belt buckle. You don't have a fashionable bandana like I have. So I can't let you pass by.
I'll bet if we were wearing rustler costumes, we could fool that guard.
But we only have one.
What do you think?
It might be a little big for you.
But do I look like a rustler?
Oh! Yes!
Just to think about it.
Wow! That's kind of scary! I'd almost believe you were a rustler.
Good! That's what we want.
That's a great rustler disguise, Freddi.
Thanks, Luther. I hope it fools the guard. Luther, you stay here while I try to get past the guard.
Wait, I'm coming with you.
Good thinking, Luther. Let's try to get past the guard.
Hold it! This is a... Well, howdy, fellow rustler.
Ahem, howdy.
I reckon Mr. Big must have sent you to help us out with the hogfish, right? Poor Maury. He's having a terrible time with the hogfish. Well, go on in. He'll be glad to see you.
Thank you.
We did it! Shh. We did it. We're inside. Which way do you think the hogfish are?
Well, I think I hear squealing coming from...
Hey! You two aren't rustlers! What are you doing here?
We were just leaving.
You're not going anywhere! Mr. Big will know what to do with you.
What is it?
Nobody knows the trouble I've seen. What do we do now?
You swim through the bars.
It didn't even budge.
Nope, this door is definitely locked.
He took all our stuff.
Hey, it looks like there might be a way out under all these cannonballs.
Phew! These are heavy! There! That does it. Are the missing hogfish, all right?
We're not missing. We know just where we are.
They can talk?
This little piggy went to market. This little piggy stayed home.
Oh, no. Not again. Did you come to rescue us?
That's right.
Good. The food in here is terrible.
By the way, I'm Freddi, and this is Luther.
My name's Gruntle. I'm glad you're going to rescue us. It's really crowded in here.
Maybe we can get the hogfish out through this hole.
The hogfish won't fit through there, but it looks like you and I can.
I guess we'll have to work out another way to get those hogfish out.
They'll need a bigger opening.
That anchor looks really heavy.
I'll bet that weighs 6 tons.
What does that mean?
That means it's really heavy.
Oh. I wonder what this does. Neat! Why is the anchor on this chain?
So the anchor stays attached to the boat when you drop it.
I wonder if this will bring the anchor back up.
This is a nice, sturdy chain. The chain won't quite reach the bars.
But
maybe we can make it longer.
Okay.
Anchor up the port bow!
It's nowhere near long enough now.
Okay, that doesn't really make any sense.
Do you think you could pull up the anchor with the chain?
No, I think you'd get pulled right off the boat. The anchor's awfully heavy.
Oh! Hoist the anchor, Hoskins. We set sail for the new world! Maybe I could use this chain to yank those bars out. I think I see something behind this thing.
Right. I can't see it very well. The rudder's in the way. I think we have to move this rudder if we're going to get that thing out of there.
Then move it. Why don't you move it?
Phew!
This is hard work!
There must be an easier way to move it.
Okay, no, I didn't actually want it.
Phew!
won't budge.
We'll have to find some other way to move it.
Look, I'm the captain.
Did you hear something?
Like a creaking noise?
I think it came from out there.
Look at this neat hook! Do you think maybe it belonged to a pirate?
I don't know. But I bet it will come in handy.
Here, why don't you hang on to it?
Okay.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea. He's gonna maim someone with that.
If we attach this hook to the chain, it'll reach those bars.
It's like in Silent Hill 3, except this is nothing like Silent Hill 3.
This should free those hogfish. Luther, prepare to drop anchor.
Ready, Freddi!
Fire away!
What? No! Come back!
Please come back!
We're going home. The food's terrible here.
Oh, what do we do now, Maury?
Find a better hobby?
I think you should give yourselves up.
You're under arrest in the name of the law!
Law? What law?
Yeah, I don't see any law.
Then I suggest you turn around! Real slow-like.
It's Sheriff Shrimp!
Yeah, and just about everybody in town, it looks like.
And everyone
Youngsters,
else.
Youngsters, that was mighty fine work apprehending these two. I'll be taking them off to jail now. You boys ought to be ashamed of yourselves.
Hold on, Sheriff. There's one more person involved with the rustling.
Yeah, that's right. They kept talking to somebody called Mr. Big. I never saw his face, but he was in charge. He planned the rustling and everything.
Is that so? Well, what if it is? We'll never reveal the identity of Mr. Big.
Yeah, you'll never catch him.
Actually, I know who Mr. Big is. He's right here in the room. When the rustlers caught Luther and me, they called Mr. Big to come and decide what to do with us. I suspect he was already here when you all arrived and just slipped in with the posse.
Well, which one is it then?
Phil, when we were at the soda loon and we found the note telling the rustlers to meet here, you made a phone call to someone. You were talking about the note.
Well,
what? That was Luther talking right there.
Later on, you made another call. This time you were talking about singing.
Why is Freddi speaking through?
Piggy.
Well, sure.
And when we got here and found the hogfish, I noticed this.
What's that?
It's sheep music, Sheriff. The sheep music to this little piggy, to be exact.
No need to go on. It's my music. Moray was having trouble getting the hogfish to sleep, so I suggested he try singing this little piggy to them.
Fat lot of good that did.
Phil, does that mean that you're...
I'm Mr. Big. Yes. I never meant to hurt anybody, you understand? It's just that I've got 17 children, and I don't make that much as a piano player. I thought hogfish ranching might bring in a little extra cash.
Well, that's no excuse. You all ought to be ashamed. You just shouldn't take things that don't belong to you. It hurts other people, and it's just plain wrong.
You're right.
We're sorry.
We didn't want to be rustlers. All we ever really wanted was to be hogfish ranchers, but we don't know how.
Ranchers, you say? You know, I do still need some help out at my place.
I'm glad this worked out so well for everyone.
Freddi, Luther, I can't thank you enough for all you've done here. The hogfish are home safe.
And the rustlers is brought to justice. Yeehaw!
How's their immunity service working out?
That's community service, son.
Oh, yeah. How's that going?
I think they're coming along quite well.
It's not really punishment because this is what they always wanted to do.
It's hard work, but when I'm done with them, they'll be real hogfish ranchers.
Can we learn to be hogfish ranchers, too?
No.
Of course. Here, I've got something for you.
10-gallon hats?
Yours is a 5-gallon, so it'll fit just right.
Oh, boy!
Now, come on, you two. I'll show you how to tie a lasso.